Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Hey, welcome back to the COD Show podcast. News, breaking news update. All right. That's right. Let's get straight to it. Well, my bad. I'm your host, Didi Onassis, a.k.a. Onassis Killem. Welcome to the COD Show podcast news update. The Call of Duty news update. Okay. Okay. So, patch update 1.04 for Call of Duty Black Ops 4 is live now on PlayStation and Xbox. For PlayStation, 11 gigabyte of memory was used for this update. Xbox One, 12 gigabytes. The PC will be updated tomorrow, October 31st, Halloween. All right. So let's talk about the patch notes. The patch notes for multiplayer. Okay. Playlist updates. They've got a new game. The new game mode in the game, Gun Game, is added to the playlist, the featured playlist, along with Mercenary Team Deathmatch, Mosh Pit. Okay, my bad. Mercenary Deathmatch, Mosh Pit. And Chaos Domination. Chaos Domination will include a 3-second capture. Okay, so you can capture the zone in 3 seconds. But check this out, it's more. 150 point rounds, 6v6, okay? So it's 150, you're going up to 150, not 100, and it's 6v6, okay? Salute to that. Let's talk about the hardcore team deathmatch and hardcore kill confirm game modes. Player count boosted it up 1-1-1-1, 6v6. Salute to that. 2 specialists limit per team. So you don't have to fight over recon or crash anymore, all right? It's, hey, man, come on. That's what's up. Let's get it. Assault rifles. Okay. They're saying that they want to close the gap between the assault rifles and the SMGs. So, a lot of our favorite assault rifles are taking a nerf. Okay. Okay. So, let's talk about it real quick. The ICR. Reduced headshot damage. Slight reduction to reload speed. That don't sound good. That don't sound fair at all. All right. The Vapor. My favorite weapon in the game. Salute to that. Reduce close range headshot damage. Okay. Damage now falls off sooner. High caliber. Reduce headshot multiplayer. Whatever. So they're saying they're taking, it's taking a slight nerf. Okay. Damage fall off sooner. But that may be a different. Damage falls off sooner. That ain't good. Alright. Okay. But I played with it a few minutes ago. Everything's still fine. It's still a melt machine out there in hardcore. I don't know about core. Okay. Let's keep on talking about it. Let's talk about it. Where we at? The SMGs. Okay. Mop. They want you to move from point A to point B around the map a lot faster and be a lot more efficient and competitive during gunfights with the SMGs. And some of them, they're saying that some were good, some were bad. Let's talk about the MX9. Okay. They buffed it. They extended all damage ranges for the MX9. It needed that. All right, salute to that. The Cordite, extended all damage ranges. Same thing. The operator belt feed for that mod. That operator mod increased overheat rate. Okay, so it's going to get overheated quicker. The GKS, quad shot operator mod, slight time increase in between burst. The Sauce 9mm. The dual wield operator mod, reduced hip fire accuracy. So that's taking a little nerf. All right. Tactical rifles. They're talking about the tactical rifles. They're saying that the tactical rifles were OP. Some of them received a nerf, some received a buff. Let's talk about it. The ABR223, extended maximum damage range. Okay, so damn, I don't know if that extended maximum damage range, that gun is already OP in my opinion. The repeater operator mod now takes longer to accurate fire rate. It now takes longer to accelerate fire rate, not accurate fire rate. All right, stock, slight reduction in movement speed bonus. Laser sight and laser sight 2, improved hip fire accuracy. The Swordfish, high caliber. All right, it's saying is a possibility of a 3-hit kill. Okay, salute to that. The Pentaburst operator mod, reduced extra granted clip size. Okay. Little nerf. Does he get it? The sniper rifles. Okay, so they've bumped up some of the sniper rifles to catch up with the Paladin HB50. Okay, so they're saying that the High Caliber 2 on the Paladin, it takes longer to get the kill when someone has full tac and armor. All right, so it would no longer be a one hit kill if you have full tac and armor. All right, FMJ 2, improved damage against score streaks. Stabilizer 2, player can now hold breath sooner after the previous hold breath. Okay, that's a little buff. Let's get it. The Outlaw, improved base damage from 110 to 130. All right, reduced idle sway, increased base movement speed and stop, slight increase in ADS movement speed bonus. Okay, the SDM, increased clip size from 10 to 12. Okay, reduce idle sway, little buff with the SDM sniper rifle. Okay, the Kashka, improved damage from 120 to 140. Woo! All right, stock, slight increase in ADS movement speed. All right, let's get into the LMGs baby. All right, the Titan, let's talk about this slight machine. The LMGs, some in the community have discovered that the Titan and VKM 750 are extremely effective weapons. We're toning them down. Come on, son. All right, let's talk about it. The Titan received a nerf, reduced headshot damage, reduced hip fire accuracy, stock, reduced ADS movement speed bonus. The VKM 750, all right, the LMG, the VKM, reduced movement speed while firing, reduced damage slightly. Fat barrel operator mod, reduced bullet tracer size. All right, I need to level mine up so I can see what that's all about. That fat barrel operator mod, that sounds dope. The Hades, one of my favorite weapons in the game. The crossbar operator mod, reduced movement speed and accuracy. Steady grip, improved recoil. Let's talk about it. The pistols. I know some of y'all about to pull y'all hair out about over these pistols, man. I mean, it's fun to use, but let's talk about them real quick. Slight reduction to ADS and transition speed for all pistols. Okay, the RK7 Garrison. Slight increase to the time between burst, slight reduction to reload speed. Okay, it's receiving a little nerf. All right, okay. Shotguns. Oh, man. Shotguns, okay. This weapon class is close to where they want it, with only a couple specific attachments performing better than intended. Shotguns in Black Ops 4 play a different role than in the past Call of Duty titles. And those who have practiced cat and mouse gameplay can be highly effective with them. All right, let's talk about it. The MOG-12, choked barrel, one hit kill range reduced. Dragon's Breath operator mod. This is the MOG-12. Resolved an issue where the Dragon's Breath occasionally triggered incorrect visual and sound effects on targets. The SG-12, strobe light operator mod, addressed an issue with the strobe light where it would remain on after death. That's a fact. Live update coming soon to reduce the range at which the strobe light interferes with an enemy. Please take that shit all the way out of the game, man. Come on, man. Let's talk about the attachments for all weapons. I don't want to talk about the attachments for all weapons. We're going to skip that. Don't really want to talk about the specialist. Ajax, nah. Let's talk about it. Let's see what they've done to Recon, everybody's favorite specialist. Intelligence wins wars. The Recon is living proof. We have intelligence that Recon's intelligence is too good. So we're reclassifying some of his sources. What does that mean? Reduce sensor dart duration. So I didn't think the sensor dart lasted that long, but they're cutting down that time on the sensor dart. All right. Resolve an issue where voiceover would incorrectly state that the player's sensor dart was destroyed. That's a fact. All right. Let's talk about Crash, one of my favorite players. While we're happy that our support specialist is so popular, he is a bit too effective as a score streak farmer. Come on, son. Reduce teammate use pack score event from 50 to 25. Come on, bruh. Can't let us have no fun out here, man. All right. Okay. Dave updated the spawns, which I've noticed in Hardcore Kill Confirmed. Okay. They've done some things with the spawns in Team Deathmatch, Domination, Hardpoint, Free for All, Control. Pretty much all the game modes. Okay. The gear, the stem shot. The stem shot increased time to fully heal the player. Wow. They don't know what they want to do with that stem shot or that reheal. Armor. Resolved an issue where armor protected from more damage than intended when hitting areas of the body that have damaged multiplayers such as the head or upper chest. This primarily affects weapons with chest modifiers such as sniper rifles or weapons with high caliber too. The acoustic sensor. Reduced the range at which sprinting enemies are detected. The acoustic sensor. Reduced the range at which sprinting enemies are detected. I had to say it twice. Perks. The perks. Dead silence. Let's talk about dead silence. Y'all done the dead silence, bro. Reduced player movement, volume, and distance that players equipped with dead silence can be heard by enemies. Reduced the movement volume. Okay. The intention for dead silence is not to be completely silent, but also not to allow enemies to hear your movement from longer distance. Engineer. Extraction helicopter in heist. Don't care about that. Score streaks. Okay, so I'm noticing that they don't have anything in here about cold-blooded or ghost. Okay, we needed something done to cold-blooded and ghost, in my opinion. Cold-blooded is broken. It does not work, my opinion. All right? So let's talk about the score streaks. The Mantis resolved into an issue where the Mantis could be destroyed by touching the out-of-bounds area of the map. I did not know that. I do realize that sometimes my Mantis will get caught up in the doorway or start doing some damn cartwheels once it gets next to a rock or something like that, man. But anyway, the strike team. Let's talk about the strike team, bro. Oh, boy. Strike team. Prevented strike team kills from contributing towards owner's kills without dying medals. Now, does that mean? The way they've worded this, I have no idea. I hadn't been out there in these Call of Duty streets to try to get a nuke thus far since this update, but man, does that mean that the strike team kills count toward the nuclear medal? Does it? All right. I can go either way with it. I like it. All right. So whatever. It's not like we're blowing up the map anyway. All right. It's all good. What else we got? What else? Game modes. Increased XP earn rate in heist. Wow. Okay. It's all blah, blah, blah. What else we care about? We don't care about nothing else. Blackout. Okay. They've increased the player count in solos to 100. Okay. That's dope. The armor in Blackout. Armor now allows more damage to pass through to areas of the body that have damaged multiplayers, such as the head, upper chest. For example, headshots now do more damage against level 3 armor. Character missions. Unlock remaining specialist character missions. Battery, Firebreak, Nomad, Prophet, Ruin. Okay, I'm not versed in that, but I'm pretty sure it means something to somebody. All right, let's keep going, baby. Calling cards and challenges. Resolved an issue where completing Dark Ops challenges would not unlock the associated calling card. Okay. All right. So socially, players can now invite players who are online but not in the game to their in-game party. I think I like that. All right. But yo, that's it. I think that's it. Short and sweet. All in all, I hadn't spent but maybe an hour on the game since the update, but I'm still happy. I'm still out here in these Call of Duty streets, man, putting my time in the game because I love this game. Black Ops 4, salute to y'all. Y'all hadn't messed up the game yet, all right? I'm going to give y'all time. I still really don't care for the black market, but hey, it's all good. Yep. But yeah. Short and sweet, man. Salute to Charlie Intel. This is my source for great information. Salute to him, charlieintel.com. All right. I got to cite my sources. I am not a faker. I am not a loser. Let's get it. But yeah, as always, man, live life, be great, show love, and always keep the kill feet lit. It's been your guy, Billy Old Nasty, a.k.a. Old Nasty. Kill him. COB Show Podcast News Update. Ah. Kill him. Let's get it.